how many times did I flip that coin into this bowl to get the 10 heads and tails in a row? Well, I can confirm it actually took me 939 flips. So thank you so much to everyone who had a guess. We actually ended up with 10,000 comments under that original video. Yes, we had 10 to the 4 comments. And I will explain a bit more about the process for actually flipping the coin into the bucket, because those 939 flips actually included me doing it twice. Yes, I did 10 flips in a row once, but the filming didn't work out. I'll show you that footage in a moment. But initially, here are the 10 people who were the closest. Caruana, she was the all-time number one winner. She guessed 938. She wasn't the only one who guessed 938 though. She was closely followed by someone whose name was fitting, I guess. Followed by Klemens Edler. Oh, I'm gonna get this wrong, sorry. Wessel van Persie, and then, oh goodness. Okay, Bjørn-Inge. I'm gonna get your name wrong, but I'll give it a go anyway. Flølo, Kleppe. I'm sorry if that's horribly wrong. All five of those people guessed 938, followed by some people who guessed 937. Chance Strokes, Death Vader 10, Brandon Allaire, and Owen Ball. So, congratulations to those people. My goodness, these are a bit more worse for wear. Now, your prize is not gonna be me mispronouncing your name. I mean, that's part of the prize. I'm actually going to give you a copy of my book. So I've got 10 copies here of Things to Make and Do in the Fourth Dimension. As you can see, I have numbered them 1 through 10 down the spines. So when you get your book, you can double check it was the one actually in the video. And so I'm gonna get the people who won a prize to send me their details. I mean, I'll be in touch anyway. Let me know what you want me to write inside the book and I'll post them off to you as soon as I can. Now, the more observant of you may have realized that I only read out 9 names and I promised 10 prizes. There are actually 10 copies of the book I have to send out. And the problem is, while no one guessed 939, if you have a look on the bar chart here, you can see that only 5 people were within 1, no one guessed 1 above. And if you expand it out, you've got 9 people within 2. Again, the 2 spots above it are empty. I can't keep expanding that out because if I go 3 each way, there's an additional 13 people who suddenly come in to the prize category. So what I'm gonna do for those 13 people who were nearly there, I'm going to cut up the balloons that were in the previous video where I actually flipped the coin, and I'll sign a section of the balloon and I'll send it out to you. I'll give it to the top 9 people as well. You can use it as a bookmark. As for who I'm going to give the 10th book to, that is going to go to someone called Oliver Dunk. Oliver Dunk is a programming prodigy. He put together a script that would go through all of the 10,000-ish comments on the video and pull out all the numbers in them and put them onto a spreadsheet. And he actually spent hours both working on the code and he sat there trawling through loads of false positives. So thank you so much, Oliver, for all of your hard work. Without you, I would have taken even longer to finally do this video. You can have book number 10. Going back to the bar chart, you can see that the correct answer, 939, is really in the wilderness as far as guesses are concerned. Not only did no one get it, but very few people were near it. There were other places where lots of guesses clumped together. If we zoom out, you can see here at 1,000. Check that out. 64 people were convinced that 1,000 would be the correct answer. I just happened to have an exact round number of flips. And if you zoom further out, 1024 was quite the popular guess. In fact, that was the most popular guess, with 188 people all committing to that one guess. In case you're curious, I actually worked out the most popular guesses in the competition, and they fall into 3 distinct categories with 2 outliers. First up, you can see here we have all the guesses which were powers of 2. We had loads of those, 10, 24, 2, 5, 6. I'm including 1023 because a few people thought 10, 24 would be the answer, and so they went one below to the nearby Mersenne number. As well as powers of 2, we had a whole lot of round numbers. People love these. 1,000, 200, 250, 150, 600 just sneaking in there. 100,000. Curious guess, and 36 people guessed 1. I have no idea how I could have gotten 10 flips in a row by flipping a coin once, but good on you guys for trying. We also then had the comedy entries, number 42, unsurprisingly coming in right at the top. We had 314, 10 times, oh sorry, 100 times pi. We had 666, 420, unexpectedly beating out 1,337. Young people these days, and then 1, 2, 3, 4 making an appearance at the end there. And then the two outliers, very interestingly, were 2046 and 2036. And you think, well, why did so many people guess those two numbers? And it's because those people did some maths. So we'll start with 2036 first, quite a popular guess. These people tried to calculate how many times would I have to flip a coin into a bowl on average to get 10 flips in a row. And their logic was, if I have a run of 10 flips, which I'm going to call 10 A's, just to avoid the whole head and tails confusion. And you think, how many runs of 10 flips are there? Well, 2 to the power of 10 is 1024. So there are 1024 possible runs of 10 flips. But the thing is, if I start flipping this coin and it's not what I want, I'm going to abandon it. And half of them go wrong on the very first flip. So if A is what we want and B is what we don't want, a full 512, half of those start with a B. In those cases, I'll flip it once and go, that's not what I want, and I'll stop. Now, a quarter of the total flips, 256 of them, the first one will be right, it'll be A, but then the second one will be B, and then I'll stop. And so for those 256, I'll flip it twice. For a remaining quarter of all the possible runs, I'll get the first two correct and then wrong on the third one. So that means I'll have 128 occasions where I do 3 flips. You can carry on, I'll have 64 occasions where I do 4 flips, 32 occasions where I do 5, and so on all the way down. And if you add them all together, you end up with a total number of flips for all the strings which have gone wrong of 2,036. And that's why a lot of people guessed 2,036. Very sadly, that is not correct. It's so close, people who tried to work that out. They forgot about the actual run, which is correct. If you add together all the cases they've done, there are only 1,023 of them. They've forgotten the 1,024th case, which is the run of A's, exactly what we're after. And so if you add on the final 10 flips to actually get the correct answer, that's where the 2,046 came from. But here's the problem with probability. Of all the areas of mathematics before probably research mathematics, anything you do at school or undergraduate degree level, probability is the thing where it's so easy to get it wrong, because it's not just a case of crunching through the logic to get to the answer. You've got to think and remember all the cases and all the possible things that can happen, and it's the one area that trips up so many people. And it's the area where I'm always the least confident with an answer. And so 2046, how do I know that's the right answer? I mean, I convinced myself, but how do I know I haven't forgotten something along the way? But the great thing about probability is both the area where it's the easiest to make a silly mistake, it's also the area of maths where there's a shortcut. You can just hack your way to the answer by doing an experiment. You can run a simulation. And so I quickly wrote some Python code to simulate flipping a coin over and over, and I recorded how long it took to get to a run of 10, and then it started again. I left that going overnight. It did it 50 million times, and the average number of flips required to get 10 in a row in the simulation after 50 million attempts was 2,045.97. So I'm fairly confident 2,046 is the correct number of expected flips. So why was the correct answer 939, nowhere near 2,046? And obviously it could just be because I got lucky. It's actually because I cheated slightly, and not in the way everyone thought. A lot of people said, if you watch the footage, I have the coin up one way, and when I flip it, it lands the other way, which happened to occur then. But that was purely coincidence. What was happening was, when I pick it up, I happen to flip it most of the time the same way as it was when I picked it up in the bowl. But if you watch the footage, it bounces all over the place. I know you can learn to flip a coin very carefully. I am too lazy for that. That is not what I was doing. My one cheat is, if you look at the footage, there is a single edit in the entire video at 1 minute and 17 seconds. And that's before I did the flipping, for the record. So I did those 10 flips legitimately, that all happened. All I did to slightly cheat was, I did the flipping first and then I recorded the beginning of the video to say what I was going to do. And actually, for every single flip, because this coin is blue and yellow, and so I could decide either side, it's head or tails, when I flipped it, I looked to see what the first one was. In this case, it's yellow, and I declared that to be heads. I then did the second flip, and if it was the same as the first flip, I pretended I wanted to get 10 heads in a row. If it was different to the first flip, I then pretended I wanted to get alternating heads, tails, heads, tails, heads, tails. And so by recording the beginning of the video second, I could decide which was heads, which was tails, and if I was going for a run all the same, or if I was alternating all the way down. And so in reality, I was actually only trying to get 8 particular flips in a row, because I got the first 2 for free. And then, because I love data, after every single run of flips, I would record that number in a spreadsheet. I had my laptop just down the side here. You can actually see its glow on my arm coming off the screen. In hindsight, I should have turned the screen down, but what are you gonna do? And so the system was, I'd flip it twice, whatever that was my run. I would then carry on. And I just had to do that upbeat chat every single time. I had to remain consistently enthusiastic. It would normally go wrong quite quickly, which is why I do the first 5 flips really quickly. The first 2 I get for free, the next 3 I would do super fast, because 7 out of 8 times it would end within those 3 flips. Only if I got 5 in a row would I then slow down and enjoy the rest of the chat. So for your own personal entertainment, here are the first few attempts when I began filming it. Okay, here we go. First flip is heads. All right, second flip, heads again, off and racing. In fact, the first 4. Oh. Okay, here we go. First flip is, come on. Man, if they all take this long, it's gonna take three. Oh, here we go, yes. Heads, all right. Second flip is gonna give us, there it is, come on. Tails, all right, hopefully this will speed up as we go along. Next one, heads again. There we go, and then tails. In fact, the first 5 are the easier ones. Oh. Okay, here we go, flip number 1, and there it is, heads. All right, off and racing, number 2. There we go, tails. In fact, the first 5 are pretty straightforward. There's... Okay, here we go, first flip, nice and straight. And it goes on in that fashion for about an hour and a half of that noise. If you want to watch all an hour and a half of the footage, I have uploaded it to my other second channel. You can watch it, flip through, you can check it, you will see all 939 flips. I will also make available in the description below a download of the spreadsheet of how many times I flipped it. And there are some real highlights to look for in the footage. You will notice, if you just check the spreadsheet, that there are a few entries with 1 flip. And this is the other reason why people's maths wasn't quite right. The mathematics assume you only stop when you get the wrong flip. I occasionally missed the bowl. I didn't always get it in the bowl. I also occasionally got it in the bowl and then it flew back out again. And all the times the coin ended up on the ground, I simply stopped, recorded the number, and started again.
Am I not a good start?
If I pick that up, can I keep going, or are you guys not going to believe I've done this properly?
Come on.
Where's the one gone?
Goodness.
Lock that as one. All right, let's get this thing Okay. The other highlight in the footage is when I got 10 in a row. I actually got 10 heads, yellow side, in a row earlier on, but then the filming didn't work out. So as you saw in the final video, when I got it right, these balloons came racing up. I had them all rigged up, so I kicked something over and they all flew up simultaneously. I also had a confetti cannon, because I wanted the balloons to go, and then boom, confetti everywhere. It'll be hilarious and celebratory. Sadly, it didn't work. The cannon, I set it off and just went poof, and just nothing. It was meant to be a big air blast and it must have been, I don't know, faulty. And so I'm going to show you that footage. Here's me getting 10 heads in a row, and then you can watch my soul slowly dissolve as the big celebratory effect didn't work. Okay, let's start this thing. First flip, there we go. Yes, heads. All right, so far so good. Second flip, heads again. What are the chances? Well, actually, I find the first five flips are really easy. You pretty much just chuck it in there five times, you end up with five heads. It's only after the first five, which you pretty much get for free, that it starts getting a little bit more, well, difficult. So I struggle with six and seven. I mean, eight is a piece of cake. Six and seven, quite tricky. Here we go, ready? This is six. Come on, nice. And then seven, nearly out of the woods. Yes, seven. And as I said before, eight, piece of cake, just chuck it in there. All right, here we go, nine. Now, nine and 10 take a bit of focus, because frankly, there's only a one in a thousand dish chance I'm gonna get this. So here we go, there's nine. And then finally, for 10 heads in a row, we have 10. There it is, ladies and gentlemen. Whoa, that was meant to, oh, where's my party in a tube? Well, that's something, I guess. So, ladies and gentlemen, I got a party in a tube that didn't even go off. I just flipped five heads in a row and I don't get a party. What? Oh, now I'm annoyed. Are you kidding me? So there you are, 10 heads in a row. I had a confetti cannon and it didn't go off. Who would have thought the confetti cannon was the most unpredictable, random part of this ridiculous video? But there you are, I'm just... And so I sat there thinking, oh, should I do it again? Or was that good enough? I mean, I did the whole rambling close. If you watch the raw footage, you can see I did the whole thing, thinking maybe I could edit it and save it. And that was on the 251st attempt. I had flipped this coin 914 times. And I thought, you know what? I should do it again. I've just got to mentally reset. I've got to calibrate like nothing ever happened, put back on all the enthusiasm and begin again. I could be here for another 1,000 flips. But amazingly, I then got it on the sixth go after I started back up again. You can watch the footage, it's something else. And there was only another 25 flips until I got the alternating heads, tails, heads, tails, heads, tails that you saw in the final video. So given I actually only did 8 flips in a row, but I had 2 bonus flips at the beginning of each run to determine what those 8 should be, what was the actual mathematical prediction? If we actually work out 8 flips from our previous method, the prediction is 510 flips. How far off was I? Well, I had, for the first run, when I got the first 10 heads in a row, I flipped the coin 914 times. But you've got to remember that was 251 goes, and I flipped the coin twice at the beginning of each one to determine what those 8 had to be. So if you subtract those off my total, and you subtract off the one bonus flip, because I didn't just stop at 10, I always did an 11th flip, because why stop while you're still in front? And if you take them all off, the actual number of genuine flips where I was going for a run of 8 was only 411. So I came in 100 under on the long run, and I got extremely lucky when I had the short run afterwards. One last thing to clear up. When I set the challenge originally, I said no guessing or the average of what everyone else has guessed, the so-called wisdom of the crowd method. But out of curiosity, how good were you all as a collective? And I have the results here. Of the 10,000 comments, we were able to get 8,950 genuine entries. And if you average everyone's guesses across them, the average guess for the number of flips was 426,239.3 flips. You think, hang on, that was nowhere near the correct answer. This crowd isn't very wise. Well, that's because there were a few massive guesses, some real outliers at the extreme end who guessed millions or billions of flips, and that dragged the average up. And so I thought, well, I better get rid of those. And so if you only average all the guesses which were under a million flips, of which there were 8,866, the average number of flips was 2,036.3. So pretty much the theoretical correct answer of 2,046. Freakishly, it's a little bit disturbing, it's spot on the incorrect version of the working out. So there you are, 2,036. I mean, that's probability. You get these freaky things all the time. If you want to be truly disturbed, look at what happens if you take all the answers which were under 10,000. Because I thought, actually, the guesses, realistically, the serious ones are going to be sub 10,000. So if you average all 8,758 guesses which were below 10,000, the average was 939.5. And that, I mean, that is really creepy. All the 10,000 below guesses together were spot on. I mean, you could argue that would round up, but come on, that is alarmingly close. Okay, there is something a little bit like confirmation bias going on here, because you could argue I would keep choosing different thresholds until I got something close enough to the correct answer. But still, 10,000 is a pretty obvious round number threshold to pick, and 939.5, that is just crazy close. So, I mean, congratulations. If anything, this speaks volumes for the caliber and intelligence of the people who watch my videos. So, well done, everyone. Once again, you've proven yourself to be fan-flipping-tastic. Actually, once again, I am going to try and give a gift to everyone who got involved, or indeed just anyone who wants it. In my previous video, where I gave away the solution to the three indistinguishable dice puzzle, I had 97 dice that I gave away, and they went incredibly quick. I'm sorry, they were gone within half an hour of me putting the link up. And people kept buying things on Maths Gear afterwards, saying, please, if there's any left, could I have one? I felt bad that I didn't have any left. So what I actually did was I took the two decks of cards that were in my Maths card trick video from a little bit earlier on. Oh yeah, there may be a deck swap in that. And I signed all the cards and I put them in envelopes with little notes saying this is card from deck one or deck two from that video, with a little certificate that proves it. And I've been giving those away instead. And I've still got a few left. So if you do buy anything on Maths Gear and you say, hey, I love the videos, can I have a thing? I will put one of the remaining cards in. I'm very aware I've only got 20 or 30 left and they're going to go as quickly. So if you buy anything on Maths Gear and you say, can I have a thing? If you can't get a card, what I'm going to do is, because I've got a decent amount of balloon left, and I'm going to give this to the top 22 winners of the coin flipping challenge. All the remaining balloon I'm going to cut up, I'll sign it all, I'll put it in bags with a wee certificate saying this is from the video and which of the three balloons it was from. If you just actually want to be guaranteed to get something I've signed, of course you can buy my book, Things to Make and Do in the Fourth Dimension. If you buy it on Maths Gear, they are all signed, and if you leave a note saying, could Matt write my name in the book, I will happily deface it and write your name inside. And if you are super nice, I will write your name out in binary code. So there you are, something for everyone. Hooray! So that's it for flipping a coin into a bowl over and over again. Now there are actually two puzzles I need to conclude. There's the how many times did I flip the coin, and there's the three indistinguishable dice puzzle, which is what I'm going to cover now. So if you